Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Scratch Learners. Today we will discuss about searching operation in an array. We will discuss about the linear search, its algorithm with an example, and the equivalent source code. So what is searching? Searching operation refers to finding the position of desired element in an array. As the word suggests, searching simply refers to the process of finding an element from the array. We can find the position of a given data element using two different searching techniques. The first one is linear search and the second one is binary search. So today let's discuss about linear search. In the next video we will discuss about binary search. So what is linear search? The linear search technique is used when there is no knowledge whether the data is in sorted order or not. That means this linear search is used when we have no knowledge about the arrangement of the elements of the array. So how does this method works? In this technique, we compare the desired element with all the other elements of the array. So we fix a desired element that we need to find from the array. We will compare all the elements of the array with that desired element, right? That means in this technique, we start comparing the desired element with the element present at the first position in the array. Then we compare it with the element at the second position of the array. So this procedure continues until the desired element is found or we reach at the end of the array. If the desired element is matched with any element of the array, then the search is successful. So in this way, we find out the desired element from the array. Or if we reach the end of the array, then the searching is incomplete, or that means the searching is unsuccessful and there is no element which is matched with the desired elements. Now let's begin with the algorithm for linear search. So here the first step is used for repeating the steps 2 and 3 and the loop is repeated for total number of elements in the array. So let this be the array S. We need to find out the data, okay, from this array. So these two statements will be executed for I equals to 0 to 7, right? In the step 2, the ith element of the array is compared with the desired element, that is the data. If both the elements are matched, then a message is displayed indicating that the position of the desired element found, okay? Then we will exit from the loop. So next, step 3 will be executed if the element at the ith position is not matched with the desired element and the variable I is incremented for fetching the next element in the array. Then step 1 is again performed. We will check this condition where I is less than n minus 1 or not. Then again step 2 and step 3 are repeated until we find the desired element, okay? So if once we reach the end of the array and we couldn't find the desired element, then an error message will be printed indicating that the data is not present in the array. Then we will exit from the algorithm. So let's understand this with an example. Here is the array S. These are the elements. Let's see, we need to find out the element 4 from this array. We will compare 4 with the 0th element. 8, is 8 equals to 4? No. So we will increment a value of I by 1. Then we will compare 7 with 4. They are not equal. So again we will increment the value of I. Okay. If 2 equals to 4? No. Then again we will increment the value of I. Then 4 equals to 4. So here it's true. So we found the element and we will simply display the message that the element 4 is found at index 3, right? Now if we want to search the element 15, okay, so in the same way, starting from 0, the element 15 is compared with all the elements of the array. See here, 15 is not present here. So by incrementing the value of I, we will once reach the end of the array, right? Then as the element is not present, we will come out of this loop and simply exit from the algorithm, right? So this indicates that the element 15 is not present in this array. Now the next topic is the complexity analysis of linear search, right? So in a searching algorithm, the key operation is comparison. Thus, the complexity of any search algorithm can be measured by counting the number of comparisons performed in that algorithm. So in the array, while finding the position of a given element, two cases arise. What are those two cases? The worst case and the average case. So the worst case is the case in which we find the desired element at the last position, or it cannot be located, right? So in both of these cases, the worst case complexity is order of n. Now the average case complexity. The average case complexity is to study the probability of presence of desired element at any position in the array. Okay? So if the desired element is found at the first position of the array, then only one comparison will take place. If the desired element is found at the second position, then two comparisons will take place, and so on. So in general, we can say that if the desired element is found at kth position, then there will be k number of comparisons. So to find out the average case complexity, we will calculate the average number of comparisons that may take place in finding the position of a desired element in the array, right? So the average case complexity for the linear search in an array containing n elements can be written as: if the desired element found at first position, number of comparison will be 1. If the element will be found at the second position, then the number of comparisons will be 2. How to? If the element is compared with the first element and the second element. Similarly, if the element is present at third position, there will be 3 comparisons. In the same way, if the desired element is found at nth position, then there will be n number of comparisons. So the total number of comparisons come out to be the sum of these, right? So the sum of 1 up to n is equals to n into n plus 1 by 2. So this is the total number of comparisons in n executions. So what will be the total number of comparisons in one execution? So for one execution, it will be divided by n, right? So n cancelled, and it comes out to be n plus 1 by 2. See, this is n plus 1 by 2. So here we can say that on an average, the number of comparisons that may take place will be half of the total number of elements in the array, right? N plus 1 by 2 is nearly half of the total number of elements in the array. So in big O notation, we can express the average case complexity of linear search as order of n. So big O within bracket n is the complexity for linear search. So I think you got the concept of linear search. Now see, this is the C++ code for linear search in an array. We are starting by declaring an array of size 10 and of type integer, right? At first, we will input the number of elements in the array in the variable n. Then we will input all the elements of the array with the help of a loop that will run from I equals to 0 to I less than n. Okay, and we will store the elements in the array at location I. Then we will input the element to be searched, and it will be stored in the variable data, right? Then a loop will start, which will run from the zeroth index to the last index. That means the loop will run throughout the array, and we will check if the data is equals to array at position I. That means we will simply search whether the target element is present or not. Okay, if the element is present, then we will simply display the message that the element is found at location I, that means at which index it is found, and we will assign c equals to 1. So here c is just a variable to check whether the data is found or not, right? And this loop will continue until we reach the end of the array. Okay, now if I reach the last element, then will come out of this loop and simply check if c equals to 0 or not. we have initialized the value of c as 0 in the beginning. So if c equals to 0, that means if the data is not present in the array, that means then we will display the message that the searching is unsuccessful, right? As we could not find that element. Now let's run this program. Enter the number of element. Okay, so let there be 5 elements and the element of the array. Let the element be 4, 67, 12, 43, 6. Now enter the element to be searched. Let we want to search the element 43. So see here, the element 43 is found at location 3. How? Because the array indexing starting from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay? If you start the array indexing from 1, then the element 43 would be found at index 4. Now let's again run this program and try to find out an element that is not present. So 4 elements, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Let the element to be searched be 6. See here, searching is unsuccessful. So this worked because of this statement, right? So this is the linear search program. Okay, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share the videos with your friends. Thank you.